So many are saying, no, it is not possible for the East and the South of Nigeria to be together, but for you, it's going to be possible.
Yeah.
Because Jesus is the cord between the two of you.
Amen.
Jesus will bring you together.
Yeah.
Jesus will bring you together.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Brother Loika, when you see the eyes of Sister Ujioma, the joy of the Lord will fill your life.
Yeah.
Sister Ijima, when you look at the eyes of Brother Olayinka, the job that will fill your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
With this hand, both of you will carry babies.
Amen.
You will buy properties.
Amen.
You will buy good cars.
Amen.
You will live well together.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And when the Lord will fall upon your life,
Amen.
It will fall upon your life.
Amen.
Both of you shall serve the Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The glory of God that you have not seen yet in your life, they shall manifest.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
My Bible tells me what God is going to do. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has mind conceived that which God has planned for the anointed one. What the Lord will do in your life shall be marvelous.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The great God will surface in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I declare the Spirit to support the man of God into your marriage.
Amen.
You will not fail.
Amen.
You will not fail.
Amen.
You will not fail.
Amen.
Everyone that witnessed today, they will not fail.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Success shall be part of this marriage.
Amen.
Promotion shall be part of this marriage.
Amen.
Exaggeration shall be part of this marriage.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we give you praise.
Amen.
Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus, for we pray in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Those whom God has joined together, let man put no, let no man put asunder. Amen.
Amen.
Let us repeat that. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Olayinka Alaniwaha and Ijeoma and Etumnu Madrike have agreed together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this congregation, and there too have given and pledged their troth to each other, and have declared in the same by giving and receiving the Holy Bible, which is the Word of God, an everlasting witness, and by joining of hands, I pronounce that they be living together as husband and wife from today in the name of the Father,
Amen.
And of the Son,
Amen.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Clap for Jesus. 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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. You can now come forward and shake hands while the music will be going on. Music. Come forward, roughly. Kiss your right hand and shake hands. Yes. Shake hands. You are now husband and wife. You are now husband and wife.
I'm not shaking.
Quickly, we are moving to sign the register. Quickly, we are moving to sign the register.
Oh, yeah.
your seat. We have not finished. Quickly, there is still time for this. We are going to sign the marriage register. But before we do that, I want to introduce a woman of God. This woman came specially. I spoke with her yesterday, despite our busy schedule. She's got another wedding tonight. She's a singer. She's an artist.
Oh, yeah. English.
Almighty Jesus.
Ijeoma.
Ijeoma. And Etumno Madubike.
I present this marriage certificate to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. May the Lord continue to keep you, uphold you, and sustain you. He shall be well with you. Let's clap for Jesus.
Thank you. Congratulate the newly wedded couple, and I pray that Lord will continue to uphold them and sustain them in Jesus' name. What we have done today shall remain permanent in the mighty name of Jesus. Devil will never come between you in Jesus' name. The title of my message for you this afternoon is Keys to Marital Fulfillment. Keys to Marital Fulfillment. It is our desire to find fulfillment in our lives, in our relationship. A relationship that is marked with happiness and with fulfillment, with fruitfulness. It is for everyone. It is for you, my dear sister, my dear brother, for a day like this, the bachelors. Even as married couples, we want happiness in our lives. This message is for you. Just bear with me. He sent his word, and his word healed them. The word you are going to hear will touch your life. Chapter 1, verse 3, it says, all things were made through him, and without him nothing was made. This marriage was made possible because of God and his love for your life. Amen. In the book of Genesis, Genesis 2, 21 to 24, we heard that God made woman out of man. Amen. That is, our God can make extraordinary out of ordinary. He will do that in your life in Jesus' name. Our God can make something out of nothing. If we know how to think, we will know how to think. Our God can bring hope to the hopeless. And that's why we are rejoicing today. Even when all hope is lost, our God will visit you with his own supernatural miracle in your life in Jesus' name. Our God can bring joy where there is no joy. Our God can save and deliver when they say it is finished. In that marriage of Cana in Galilee that we had, Jesus Christ performed his first miracle. He performed his first miracle because he was invited. Thank God Jesus was in that marriage. And thank God you are starting your journey. You are committing this journey into his hands. You will never live your life alone in Jesus' name. The people at that wedding, just like we are, they prepared everything, but all of a sudden, the wine ran out. They ran out of wine. Wine signifies happiness. It signifies joy. But it can happen even with all preparations. But if you have Jesus, you will not be put to shame in Jesus' name. So as you have started within, don't let nothing, don't be too busy that you will not have time for him. Because even the married couples, they will tell you that a time will come that wine will run out. Amen? But if you have Jesus, he will always fill the vacuum for you and you will not be put to shame in Jesus' name. The wine ran out. Sometimes it can be the passion that is running down, the love, the passion that you have for each other, no longer there. Sometimes it can be money. Sometimes it can be things that you need, it will happen. But remember, God is the provider. He is the source of everything. He is the creator of heaven and earth. And he will always supply your needs in the mighty name of Jesus. Man will fail you, but you will come to him. Amen. We experience that power. When they ran out of wine, thank God he was there. He said, what do you have there? And they had six barrels of, six barrels there of water jar. And he asked them to fill up those barrels with water. So what appeared to be ordinary water, the Lord used his divine power to turn into wine. So what is little? What appears ordinary in your life, with divine visitation, the Lord will turn that little to miracles in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What is not enough will become surplus in your life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He has the power to do it. And that's why you must trust in him. Amen.
Amen.
Those people, they were never put to shame. And you will not be put to shame in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Make him the ruler and the head of your home. We often read in the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, 25 to 33, that husband is the head of the house. It is true, but you are only holding that position in trust for God. God is the head of your house in Jesus' name. So you as the husband, as the head, you are holding that position in trust for him. And in the same book of Ephesians, we have that wife should be submissive to her husband. If you are submitting yourself to your husband, you are submitting yourself to God Almighty. Because your husband is already holding on in that position and is in himself and before him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Almighty Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, I beseech you, my brethren, allow God to reign supreme in your life. I'll just round up by pointing your attention to what Titus says in the book of Titus, chapter 2, verse 4 to 8. He says to the woman, you must have self-control. Amen. You must be pure in your heart. Your love must be pure to your husband. You must be a good homekeeper. Amen. You must be kind and you must honor your husband. And he advised the husband to have self-control, to be a good example at home, to be a man of integrity, and for people to see and to know that you are a serious person. In whatever you set out to do, in whatever you say, you can be taken seriously. Amen. To be a man that will have soundness of our good attributes of both husband and wife. And you are to feed your wife, care for your family, and look after your home. You do this, these are important keys. Your marriage will stand because you have already planted it on a solid rock that can never, never be moved. Man may disappoint you, remember. Friends may forsake you. Family may forsake you. Things beyond your own power may come, but your God will never, never put you to shame in Jesus' name. So also, if you make him your anchor, remember, we do have marriages that are turbulent, that are full of problems. It does happen, misunderstandings, arguments, anger. Amen. Remember what he did. He was on that sea in a boat with them. And the wind was blowing. Wind of anger, problems. Water was coming in, they were about to sink. And he just rose up and exercised his power, his awesome power. He spoke to the wind, and the wind calmed down. He said, "Be still, you this boisterous wind," and the wind listened to him. This is Jesus. This is God in your life. So, it is to every one of us, when there is anger, when there is problems, when there is trouble, if you invite Jesus, he will speak to that trouble, and there will be calmness in your life in Jesus' name. I pray things that come between relationship and cause misunderstanding will never come between you in the mighty name of Jesus. Rise up. That's the end of the word. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Time you will recall these words. These are words of God. It will always answer your directions in Jesus' name. Bow your heads for prayer. Pastor Calvin, please.
Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, when I say Jesus' name, I want to say amen, church. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for your word, the power that is in your word. The Bible says you speak your word and it will enter. Thank you for the wisdom in your word. Thank you for the power in your word. I said that thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your servant has spoken your word to the life of these people. I pray that the spirit, the power to do according to your word, may you impart it to them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because this wedding is built on the rock, I pray that your wedding, your marriage, will have no trouble in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please take your pamphlet. You will see that we have covered most items. We are bringing the service temporarily to a close now, before you start another celebration in the world. So we will be singing from the pamphlet. Page 8. Oh, thank you. It was brought to my notice earlier, found, lost and found, a wedding ring, please see me if this is yours or if somebody complains to you, a wedding ring was found, it shall be well with you. And the order of photographs at the back, please feel free, just right in front of the church there, to take photographs with the newly wedded couple. where we do immediately after this closing hymn. I would advise that we use the closing hymn as well as recessional hymn. So while, when we finish the last stanza of it, the couple will gently move out to the front where you will start taking your pictures. Amen.
Thank you. Mr. C. Ezekiel Azode Allen. The chairperson for this occasion. Round of applause for this.